changer toute sa tête, Dieu.
Hey everybody, what's up? What's going on? What happening? And I wish you have a, you know, you had a, it's always almost, you know, over the day, you know, Sunday, but still, I wish you had a blessed Sunday. I know we could have not go to church, those, the people who, you know, who go to church on Sunday, so I know we didn't have possibility to go to church, but that doesn't mean we don't have to pray at home with family. You know, we still have to pray because we are the church, as I always said. You know, we are the church. You know, so, and I hope you guys not discouraged, you know. I always encourage you to keep it positive. You know, I'm grateful myself with my family and always say thanks to God. Because, you know, not because I'm perfect, I'm better than anyone. It's just because I cover under the under God's grace, and you know, so you had this pandemic, coronavirus, you know, all over the world, you know, so I'm not really that panic, you know, as everybody, but it worries me. It's worried me, you know, but not that really worried, because I like to keep it positive because I've been through a lot, you know, a lot of situations similar where, you know, like earthquake, by example, where 3,000 people lost their lives. That was really bad, you know, airplane accident, you know, so it was hard, you know, so where I was in an airplane, and I the airplane was not able to land down, you know, so, and I was observing and going through all these things, and car accident, you know, and, you know, as I said, and I had a, you know, I had a, of, I've been going through a lot of virus. For me, those situation was a virus, you know, where I grew up with our parents, you know, brothers and sisters. I've been grow up alone, you know, so that was a big virus times in my life, you know, until God gave me a new family, a wife and the kids, you know, children. So I have a new, but before, you know, I was alone on earth, you know, but God was never leave me alone. He was always for me because I've been adopted by God, you know, so even I was an orphan, you know, with our parents, but I was never be alone, you know, I always has his angel with me, you know, living with me. So on this situation right now, you know, where people freaked out, you know, kind of going crazy, you know, my family, my wife and I, we ain't go, you know, we worried, I said, you know, it's worried us, but we ain't go that crazy, you know, about this situation. So we believe in God. We know God. God is in control. God is able to do everything. Even if I was sick or if I was in a hospital, I would still believe God is able. God is able. God is the one. God is strongest. So I would never, 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 you know, let go or feel depressed or give up of anything or give up hope. We gotta keep up with the hope, because my duty as a Christian, you know, I have to share the love of God, the hope, you know, not the resolution, you know, not say, okay, it happened, no. It's just like, be positive, you know, be strong, you know, don't give up, you know, like the, you know, like the disciple, like the, you know, the prophet of God, especially the three Hebrews, on the time of the king Nebuchadnezzar, when they refused to worship the statue, they said even they have to be dead, they're dying, they would not let go or fail their almighty God Jesus Christ. They will always keep up the faith. So this is me today, So I don't said, I don't said it's coronavirus is not, but I'm just positive about it, I mean, I take a lot of precautions, you see what I mean? I still a lot of precautions, more precautions than I used to take, you see what I mean? Because I know it's something contagious, and so I we have to be careful, but I'm not that worried because I know where I cannot be in control, God is in control, So there is a little music I'm gonna go listen, which is it being it, the singer is Bob Marley. It's talking about natural mystic, because a lot of things he said he's singing about, it just like he's preaching the Bible. But if you listen to just the music, the rhythm, you not listen to the words, you're missing a lot of stuff. That's the reason why I love listen to him. A couple of reggae, other reggae music artists, because they are so positive in their music. They're not just like those other rap music, the people talking, cursing, talking nasty thing about people, especially about women. Now, this is not me. I'm not really a big fan of rap music, unless this rap music is so positive, really something that I can learn something, So otherwise, after the gospel music, my best music, favorite one is Bob Marley or reggae. When I say reggae, just like Bob Marley, Lucky Dube, and all other stuff, But let's listen to this, about I don't know if you ever listened to, to Okay, listen to that music, okay? Let's listen to that. There's a natural mystic blowing through the air. If you listen carefully now, you will hear. Be the first trumpet. By the way, is the last. All right, the thing is, I've been losing my voice here. Yeah. So the thing he said. There is a natural mystic blowing through the air. If only you listen carefully now, you will hear. It says there is a natural mystic. The natural mystic is something that you cannot touch, but you can feel. You have to believe. But the thing is, if only you can hear carefully, pay attention, then you have the common sense, to face the situation we're living now, because those are there is a lot of natural mystic blowing through the air, but we have to listen carefully now. If we listen carefully now, you will know what's good, what's the best thing to do. So this is common sense. Listen carefully, it just to be able to distinguish the right and the wrong, and to use your common sense and to talk something positive, to be in a positive situation, in a positive being, even those situation happening around us, so we would not be afraid once you already know what happening, the words, but you have to know what's happening. You have to open your eyes to be able to understand, what's the situation we are in. We are kind of like in the end, in the end of the time, So this is the time right now to love as much as you can, to forgive, to love your family, to give your best to your family, to your wife, to your husband, to your children, to your neighbors, because there is a natural mystic floating through the air. But if you listen carefully, you will hurt. That means you will understand the situation you're living in now. You will understand what the world is offering. You know, so let's listen. Let's go back and listen. Some natural mystic blowing through the air. If you listen carefully now, you're aware. The first trumpet bites the way is the last. Okay, you remember the Bible talking about the trumpets, right? The trumpets is the signal, is a warning that God is taking action. So he said, this situation, especially in this situation, that could be the first trumpet. It's going to be the last one. You know, it's a warning. This is the trumpet that, it's a warning that, you know, the mother of nature, God giving us to understand we are the end of the time. It's going to start. It's not even the beginning, but we have the tradition of how it's going to look like, you know, if you understand carefully, you know, so you will hear. You know, and then you know this is the first trumpet, but it is the last trumpet. So it's nothing more and nothing less. So we have to understand, to be able to understand the situation or the end of the time. Don't ask me why. It used to be. See, he said things are not the way it used to be. Bob Marley singing, you know, just go ahead, go back and listen to this music. You know, the words, especially you understand. He said things are not the way it used to be. So before, things used to be much way better, you know, different. Right now, everything is just like upside down. You know, and he said, do not ask him why, you know, it is what it is, you know, things are not the way it used to be. He said, I won't tell no lie. He's not lying, because that's the truth. We got to face reality now. See, that's the reality. He said, we got to face the reality. It's not the time to back up. It's the time to face the reality. It's the time to keep moving, to keep up hope. It's not the time to give up hope. And this hope I want to share, you know, share it with you so you can share it to others. You know, smiling, give the hope, give the love. Let's share the love. You know, this is why he said, you know, so... You know, he just said he cannot answer to all the questions they ask because it's impossible to go to the past, you know, and then he won't tell no lie. So we have to listen carefully so we can hear. So when you talk, you talk less and listen more and you learning more and you become stronger. All right, now to finish, let's go back one last time and then we're gonna switch to something else.
Oh.
If you listen. There's a natural mystic blowing through the air. If you listen carefully now, you're here. Won't tell no lie. Is the last we had to suffer. Many more we had to die. Won't tell no lie. But not the way it used to be. We got to face reality now. Okay, my friends, my people, this is, you know, I was trying to share, you know, something positive, you know, keep up the good faith, the hope. Even Jesus said it, you know. Jesus said, you know, if you ever have that little faith of a faith just like big, you know, just small as it is, not big, but small as it is, you would able to move the mountains. You would able to move the oceans. But it's only if you have that little faith. You know, you don't need something big. You don't need to be perfect. It's only you need just to believe in God Jesus, the Almighty One, the Most High. You know, if you believe in God Jesus, Almighty One, no matter where you are, in Haiti, in United States, in China, and Italy, and other places where this situation is ravaging, you know, every people are kind of freaking out, you know, panicking, you know. So if you have that little faith, I'm telling you, you know, so you will see how big God is. You will see how almighty, how powerful He is. Not just because you're something special, but just because you need that little trust in God, Jesus Christ. And then you'll see. And you would not have to panic as, you know, everybody gone crazy, you know. Because, as I said, you just believe Jesus Christ is in control. You know, Jesus Christ is in control. A lot of people been dying many years ago from a lot of diseases, you know, from HIV, AIDS, you know, SIDA, from cholera, you know, from Ebola, you know, from tons, from a lot of people being killed from the war, the war first, the second one, and from all kind of, you know, other stuff, people being dying, killing. You see what I mean? But just because this one is contagious, you know, and then it's, you know, it's something different. I mean, not that different, you know, it killed people just like, you know, other different stuff killing people. You see what I mean? So it just, you know, so this is just like a warning. As Bob Marley said, that could be the first trumpet, but this is the last. It's the same warning, different sounds of warning, but it's just one. It's just the same. Just to let you know that you have to get yourself together, to be ready, you know, to be strong, to be, you know, deep in God Jesus Christ, you know, because this is the mark or the feeling of the end of the day where people want that when that day will come. You're fighting to get water, toilet paper, food over the stores, you know, where people, you know, afraid to talk to people, afraid to touch each other. Even inside of the church, people don't want to hug. Two people don't want to touch each other, you know. You know, so you see how they minimize God and compare it to this virus, coronavirus. They don't believe God is able. They don't believe God is in control. you're inside of the church, you were afraid that much. And then you said you worship the most powerful king, the most powerful God, you know, and you don't think God can take care of that. For me, it doesn't matter if I'm sick, if I was affected to this coronavirus or not. The only thing I know, God is in control. Believe that, and you will see. You will have a lot of change. You would not be afraid of this, no matter any kind of situation, especially this time. All right, be blessed. Keep it up. I love you. Lot of kisses, lot of hope to you. A lot of love, you know, all that thing. All right. My wife said, let's just let the song play, finish it, and then we can go. There's a natural mystic blowing through the air. The first trumpet, by the way, is the last. Many more we have to die, tell no lie. Elle dit, oh, quel que soit, il y a un peu de monde qui a souffert, il y a un peu de monde qui a mouru. Ça, c'est pas mentir, nous vivons. Mais c'est seulement, if we listen carefully, the natural mystic. C'est, l'homme dit, oh, there's a natural mystic floating in the air. There's a natural mystic floating through the air. It could be anything. Just like this coronavirus, anything, spiritual, whatever it is. But it's he compared things to a natural mystic blowing through the air. You have to listen carefully and you can hear. You know? One love. Peace out.